disease which his wife has, and he's also carrying a very special package on the trip.
So West is live with his story. Good morning. Good morning. He's raising awareness and raising money for MS research. We're off of 50th Street and Washington. I'm going to bring Jim in to talk to us about his center because Gary's going to come through in just a few moments. And then we're going to go ahead and turn the camera over so we can check him out as he crosses the line. Yeah. Thanks for your time, Jim.
Well, thank you for coming.
So tell us about your involvement, how you guys kind of, were looped into this thing. It's a great, great project.
Yeah, it is a great project. Gary came to us via email. He said he's making this trip down to Buenos Aires to help raise awareness and raise money. He reached out to us and said, this is going to be one of my stops along the way, and would love to meet you guys.
Tell me about your phenomenal center. I've been inside the fitness center, and you guys just do an amazing job here.
Yeah, this is a great building, and we're lucky enough to be a part of it, and it's fully accessible, fully built for people with all sorts of disabilities.
What types of things do you offer?
For the National MS Society, we offer a wide range of programs and services for people with MS and their families, and I think Gary's coming now.
Oh, here he is. Mm-hmm. Here's Gary, cruising down on a motorcycle. So, started over in Alberta, Canada, Edmonton, and now he's cruising through with a big wave of the hand, and definitely raising awareness for MS, raising some money as well for MS research. Let's walk up and chat with him for a little bit and ask him how he's doing. Gary, how you doing?
Good.
Appreciate your heart for the effort. I know that your wife has MS. Tell me about this ride and what it's been like so far.
Oh, it's been great so far. It's only been the first third of it, so it's getting the rest of the way is going to be a little bit tougher, but it's been great so far with all the MS offices that I've been to and showed how much appreciation that everyone has got for this ride.
Tell me about your, how this kind of whole thing came about.
My wife has MS. She was diagnosed in 2006. And what happened was, I always do something for MS when I was living in Toronto, Ontario area. And when we moved to Edmonton, I thought, well, what can we do? And eventually I thought, okay, I'm going to ride for the south tip of South America. I'm going to take a letter with me from a person with MS in northern Alberta and deliver it to a person with MS in southern Argentina, the south tip, and kind of unite everybody and raise awareness about MS and raise money for research to get rid of this terrible disease.
Yeah, definitely. It is terrible. What type of things, conversations have you been able to have with people? Because a lot of people may not know about MS, and some people have it when they're young, when they're older, and tell me about those discussions.
There's been a lot of discussions with various people along the road about MS and about the offices and how much the offices and the MS societies can help out everyone. They just have to contact the MS offices and see what they can do for them. They'll do whatever they can. They've been always great, and it's fantastic for the offices.
How can we follow your journey after you leave Phoenix?
I've got a GPS tracker on me, so you can tell where I am every 10 minutes of the every 10 minutes, no matter where I am, and it's on my website, www.amazingrideformS.ca, and just log on to that. They can donate for the MS and everything else, and follow me on the ride.
Awesome, awesome. You got a big group of people here.
Oh, yeah.
I'm cheering you on. Just amazing. Gary, thank you for your heart for the cause. Yeah.
Thank you. Oh, no, it's not Peter. Now smile.
There she is.